Hi, Ed Friedland, the Bass Whisperer here, and I'm very happy to show you guys my new KK Baby Bass. This is my personal instrument. It's been traveling with me with the Mavericks for several months, and it's been a game changer on stage in terms of the clarity and the punch that it's bringing. In the studio, it sounds fantastic, and I'm very excited to show it to you. I want to apologize in advance because the audio on some of the segments you're going to watch is not up to my usual standard. I was traveling with an unfamiliar camera, and the combination of my stupidity and some environmental interference, I just didn't get the best results. I've done what I can post-production to clean up the voiceover stuff a little bit. You can hear what I'm saying. The quality of the bass is really not that bad, but I do have really high quality audio in the sections where I'm playing live with the Mavericks. I've got the board audio, which is a mixture of my direct line and the mic on my amplifier, combined with the stereo mix of the band, so you really get a chance to hear what this instrument sounds like in a full band context. Well, I hope you enjoy it. Hey, Ed Friedland here. I'm taking a little break from the Mavericks 30th anniversary tour. I'm up in Canada. I'm in Kitchener, Ontario today. And I just wanted to take a little time out and show you my new KK Baby Bass. It's an instrument I just got a few months ago from KK Baby Bass. They're in the UK. They're based in London. This is a great instrument. I've been playing baby bass with the Mavericks for about 2.5 years now, and I've been using an Azola-built Ampeg reissue from the 90s. Wonderful instrument, and it's been great. But I had an opportunity to play this last time I was over in the UK, and I fell in love with the instrument. It is essentially a similar type of thing to what I've been playing, but there's a few minor improvements that have really, you know, turned out to be very significant. Gone from the original baby bass is the seam down the middle, because the originals were made of two pieces of Uvex plastic shell molded together around a foam core, and they always, the old ones, they start splitting up here. Then, you know, it's a nightmare. For touring, something like this is very, very durable, and it's been absolutely no problem. But what I'll say, the big improvement is in the pickup design. Now, he's using the classic Ampeg magnetic diaphragmatic pickup, and it produces the classic sound. Here's a side note about pickup improvements on the KK. The early models, there were complaints about low volume from the pickup, and frankly, this is exactly the same problem I had with my Azola. In passive mode. So in conjunction with a fellow named Bruce Johnson, an LA-based luthier who specializes in Ampeg scroll basses, these are electric basses that feature a similar magnetic diaphragmatic pickup design, he came up with a fix for the KK bass that involves metal washers stuck up into the feet of the bridge themselves. The metal washers on top of the magnetic diaphragm, well, it's increased the magnetic response of the pickup. And the bottom line is I get, well, I've never measured it, but I'm going to guess about 10 dB more volume. I don't need to use an external preamp. I can plug straight into the amp. And the clarity and the punch that that translates into is palpable. Yes, it is. The basic tone of the instrument works really well for all the other styles of music I play, like honky-tonk country. Blues. Jump swing. the basic texture is the same. Well, I find if I open the tone control up on the pickup, then you get this. There's a very honky mid-range there that's frankly quite unpleasant. But if you find it on your mid-range control and then you start notching it out, the sustain of the fingerboard, the string, the growl. Reminds me a bit of like a 70s Ron Carter kind of thing.
KK Baby Bass for the win, big time.